Now this little piece that was inside here, it's just a little pin, like tab. It's got an O-ring on it, so it's, you don't have to unscrew it. I found a pair of needle nose pliers. I just grabbed onto it, just like so, yanked it out. It's not very hard, but beware because there's a little spring in there that keeps the needle jet, I guess, in place and from slapping around on it. So you got to pull your needle jet out. There's a washer on both sides of it, so when you take it out, be careful with it. So bigger washer on bottom, smaller washer on top. And the guy was telling me today that if you don't upgrade these, like if you need more fuel or weigh less, then your notches will allow you to adjust. He said you can shim it, so I'm guessing that's what he was talking about by maybe getting a couple extra thicker washers to put in addition to the ones that are already underneath it. So right now you can see, maybe not, there's five grooves all together. This one's set in the middle one on number three. There's 1, 2, 3, 4. So if I set it down to the lowest setting, that's going to keep the needle raised up, so more fuel flows in. I think with the 170, I think I'm going to go all the way to the last one. So I'm going to use these needle nose. Pull this C-clip off the back of it. And from the third slot, I'm going to move it all the way down to the very bottom slot. And pop it in. And that should be it. Now I'm going to take my thicker washer, put it on the bottom again. Thinner one on top. Hold them both together so they don't fall. Feed your needle jet back into there. There's a spring that also goes in there, so I think the best way is to hold up on the bottom, put the spring over the end of your needle jet, and fall this down with it. And then take needle nose pliers. And there's a little notch right on the end of it. Let's feed it down. Find the end of it. Double check, make sure it's in all the way. And it should be just a little springy. Oh yeah, this doesn't really go anywhere. I think, so I guess the spring is if you you have it in the middle or to the end notches, it keeps it down in one spot. So, because this doesn't move at all now. So I'm just going to put my diaphragm back on. Like I said, just be careful with it. Make sure you're not poking holes in it. Because the ones for my ZX6 Ninja were not cheap. It was, you had to buy as a whole unit. It cost like $75 each. And there's four carburetors, so and just weave on the little plastic thing. So you're set back in there now. It has a specific direction that goes in. It won't let you do it the wrong way, so slide that back in there. Make sure the needle jet's in the right spot. You can stick your finger in here and guide it. Because there's a hole in there. And when you pull up on the throttle, it pulls up like that. Because there's obviously the spring in there. So it pulls up on that, and it allows more air to go through, and then the needle jet allows more fuel to go through when it gets lifted up. So tuck all your edges back into the groove for that. Figure out where you put all your parts. Your cap. Make sure that O-ring's still sitting in that little slot to the side over there. And you'll see there's a little nub for it on the cap. So make sure you put it back on that side. Put your spring back in. And I'm sure the spring goes around all that other junk that you just got put in there. Put your cap back on. Two Phillips head screws. The best idea would be to just remove everything, take it out, and give this thing a full cleaning, because I don't know who's, you know, what they've done to service this. It doesn't look like it, maybe, I mean, it looks like it's in decent condition, but who knows what they did to clean it out on the inside. I mean, this thing's an 03, so it's just 6 years old. It's probably time to, if nobody's done it, take all the ends out and give the thing a full clean down with like carb cleaner and get any kind of solidified fuel in there, any of that. So I think that's it. You just reverse assembly. I'm sorry, reverse disassembly now. And that should be it. Just pull that down, start screwing it all back, and shoot, you're set to go. Once you get the carburetor all hooked back, all your hoses, make sure everything looks, you know, right and where it was. Tighten your clamps. When you go to start it, make sure you have it on the pry, because it's going to take a while for that fuel to start getting sucked. I think the engine actually has to be running for the fuel to flow out. So keep it on primary, wait till you start your engine, then you can put it back on the on petcock position. So other than that, I think that should be it. Should you need to adjust this, this is your idle speed. So if you turn it clockwise, turn it in, it will, I believe, increase your idle speed. And if you screw it out counterclockwise, it will decrease your idle speed. So I hope I didn't bore you to death. But I noticed that out of all my videos, the ones that I have that are of my friends and I just having fun don't get too many hits, which, you know, it's just for us anyways. But I noticed some of the tutorial ones that I've done have gotten a lot of hits. So I'm thinking, you know, maybe this could actually help a couple people. So thanks for watching. I hope this helps you. If you have any questions, you know, let me know. All right, later.